now. Freeze on the line drive. Bubba!
Play a ball game, win a ball game 13-1, and watch someone else win.
Hey, what do you think of ref? I am
a ref. I'm a ref.
The refs, you know, they try. You know, they do the best job they can.
Our best. We can't be everywhere at once.
They suck, bro. I mean, sometimes you just miss the most blatant calls. It's tremendous. I don't know.
What do you think of the referees here? How do you think they do?
Pretty good.
Yeah, they seem fair. I didn't think first game a little problem, but ever since then, nothing.
First game, like what kind of
problem? Well, they can only play for 45 minutes, and then the game gets called, but they were in the middle of an inning, mm-hmm. and the referee called it, and the other team got mad. It was just kind of a little tip.
What does he think of the umps?
The umps, he can do without them.
Yeah, the umps give him a hard time?
No, not really. Mm.
But softball, they're pretty fair, or?
Softball is really good. I don't think I can remember a single game that's hinged on a call by an umpire. My team is calling me. I got to roll.
Oh, okay.
Umpires.
Run them in, run them out.
Yeah. What do you want, my impressions of an umpire?
Your impressions of an umpire. What do you think of us?
Well, I'm from Chicago, where we play 16-inch softball. And around here, they don't seem to know what that is. I don't think they think that big. I think we just had a new guest come in. It's Eric Larson. Eric, can we talk to you for a minute?
Eric, Ray.
This is Eric. Are you head umpire?
No, I'm not. I just, I suppose I have the most experience. I've been umpiring since I was a freshman, and I'm now a fifth-year senior.
Ah, so he's been around.
Well, this spring I'm doing the non-competitive league, but I have done the competitive league in the past. And it's just my impression that everyone has a lot more fun when it's not treated as though it's the seventh game of the World Series.
He's a good ump. Sometimes he gets a little carried away, but that's fine. You know, he gets into it, which is nice to see.
Uh-huh. So does he earn his money and everything? He does a good job?
Yeah, he does as good a job as everybody else, maybe even a little better. You know, yeah. Respect from other players is pretty good. Some players like him more than other players, but otherwise he's a good ump.
They ran out of baseball scorecards this week, so apparently they're using football scorecards.
It says water polo there.
Yeah, water polo, right. Well, I never worked on those games, so I wouldn't know what a water polo scorecard looked like.
What did he use that for?
This? Oh, this is an umpire's indicator. It keeps track of the ball strikes and outs. You just move each of these little wheels with your finger when the after you decide what the pitch is. So that way you keep track and you don't risk losing track of the count. I tend to enforce the rules. That's what they're there for, after all. If you're going to ignore one of the rules, you might as well throw out the whole rule book.
How did you become so familiar with the rule book? I mean, did you memorize it the first time when you started the game?
Well, you just read it over and over, like anything else, you know, that you have to study and memorize, you know. Mm-hmm. And then there are clinics or instructional sessions given twice a quarter by the IM departments, in which go over rules and positioning and things like that. So that helps quite a bit.
Have you thought about professional?
Yes, I have. After I graduate in June, I plan to go on to Harry Wendelstedt's professional umpiring school in Florida and give professional umpiring a try.
Well, there's nothing in the rules that says you can't. But then again, there's nothing in the rules that says you can't.
So it's like a constitutional thing. What do you...
Basically, you want a courtesy runner, is that right?
Yeah, exactly.
I don't see any problem with that.
Okay.
You guys are shaking hands, right?
Yes.
Okay, would you fill out your batting order, please, whoever your captain is?
We are rolling.
We got you two, our generic in the outfield.
You,
right,
you got your batting order?
Yeah.
I want to see your captain have some plays.
Looks like a training band here.
Make a call.
Those bats are just
can I see the captain,
please? Take right carry. We'll put Bach in right, Eric in left center, and Corey in left.
You got a game ball up?
Yeah, game ball. Where the hell is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Where we need it. Who's got the ball?
He said you wanted to be
right. Just play with it. We're wasting time.
All right. Captain, please. A little problem with the location of the game ball. We're just going to use the one they got.
Of the ump? I think he's a rare human being that we don't find often these days. It's totally unaware of reality and the world around him.
Right.
I think it's sort of refreshing. But call me an idealist.
Why is it refreshing?
There's a childlike simplicity about the man. A kindliness that, I mean, you can just walk up to him and you don't feel threatened at all. I like that. I like to come out to the ballpark and be able to talk to the ump like he's my 4-year-old brother.
Same at this inning.
Four runs, 15.
Okay. All right. You want to count which one scored this inning?
I know which one scored this inning.
They got
three runs this inning.
How many batters?
All right.
That guy scored. Scored.
Now listen, my man. You've had your say. Let's go back.
Carl, Miss Pelton.
All right.
What? Miscounted what?
We think that the umpire miscounted how many runs they had that inning. We think there was only three, and he thinks there was four. So that's what the controversy is about. But we just scored two more, so we're winning again. So that takes some of the edge off.
What happened there? What happened there between you and the ump?
Yeah, I thought he called me a son of a bitch, and he says he didn't. Yeah! And I think he did, but he didn't want to feel my wrath. Pardon me?
What do you think of the ump?
He's not very good. I don't want to call him an asshole or anything, but it's frustrating because he just doesn't listen. I don't think. And it's nice having two umps. He's got a tough job with only being the only man in stripes out here. But sometimes you need two people, and when you only got one, you have to suck it up and go. And he's not sucking it up enough.
I don't know if he's gonna make the big leagues though. I think he likes the authority too much, and I think he'd be too controversial.
I just keep playing, and I just keep coming out here until they tell me the season's over.